Starting with a clean model, we will create exterior images for this project in the second part of this course. We will be adding materials, models, and adjusting the camera and environment settings throughout the process. Let's begin by adding materials to the scene and learning about the many ways to create and apply them. To begin, click the plus button in the materials panel and pick Thea material from the selection. We'll rename the material and apply it to the windows. Let's click on the edit button to open the Thea material editor. The editor has two modes of operation. The full editor, which is layered base and allows for extensive editing, is available as the default mode. The other option, preset, is easier to use and sufficient for most of the materials we wish to make. Let's switch to the preset mode and from the menu select thin glass. Since the thin glass preset does not take refraction into account, it renders faster than using the glass preset. The following step is to create a metal material for the window frames. Let's go through the same process again to make a new material. Select metal this time from the list and modify the settings. Let's now look at a different kind of preset called Substance 3D, which means support for Adobe Substance 3D materials having the SBSAR extension. To load a Substance 3D material, we will click on the folder icon and select an SBSAR file to work with. Let's apply this to the surfaces around the pool. We can see that we are able to change the material's resolution and parameters specific to the Substance 3D material. Another way of adding and applying materials to the scene is by making use of the Thea content browser, which hosts materials and models. Thea comes installed with a few basic materials, but you may install additional libraries from the Thea Render website. Please find more details and links in the description. We will apply a concrete material from the Thea Concrete library. We can either double-click on the preview or use the import button to add the material to the scene. Let's also add another concrete material and apply it to the walls. Another way to access the content browser is from the material editor itself. Let's assume that we want to replace the concrete material with another one. We will click on the left arrow to expand the content browser to the left and double-click on a preview to replace the current one. We will continue adding the rest of the materials. Now that we have applied all the materials, it's time to move on to the next subject, which is beveled edges. The beveled edges option is a non-destructive way to introduce rounded edges on render time. Let's try this on some models of the scene. First, select the surfaces and switch to the properties panel. The object properties is the blue icon. All that's needed is to tick the checkbox and adjust the radius. Let's see the difference with beveled edges enabled. The next topic will go through the way of adding 3D models into the scene using the Thea content browser. First, let's open the browser window and switch to the Models tab. Again, you may get additional model libraries from the resources page, which is linked in the description. As we can see in the top right corner, there are a few options of how a Thea model is displayed into the viewport. Bounding box is the default choice and does not affect the viewport's performance. Original Mesh imports the original geometry of the model. Reduced Mesh imports the model with a reduced poly count. It should be preferred in cases where you want to have a low poly representation of the model. Full model is the same as the original mesh, with the addition that materials are also imported into the scene and available for editing. To add a model to the scene, double-click on its preview image and place it anywhere in the scene. We will do the same and add more models into the scene. One of the most important things in rendering is lighting. So, in the next topic, we're going to talk about physical sky and image-based lighting. Thea is taking Rhino's native sun and skylight into account to control the Thea physical sky. We can change the sun's position from the sun tab. More options of the Thea Physical Sky can be found in the Environment tab of the Thea Render Settings panel. One of those parameters is Soft Shadows. Higher values of this parameter can give the impression of an overcast sky. Image-based lighting is another way to illuminate the scene using high dynamic range images in EXR or HDR format. First, let's turn off both the sun and skylight from the lights panel. Let's click the browse button to load an EXR image and tick on the checkbox to enable it. We can control the rotation and intensity of the environment from the same panel. The changes we've made to the environment change the overall brightness of the scene. Here is how to control and fine-tune the exposure of the rendered image using the Display Settings tab. The default on mapping method is set to standard. The other option that we will be using is Filmic, which gives greater control over the highlights and shadows while preventing the over- or underexposure of the image. To better understand the difference, we will use the false color LUT. Let's select it from the list and tick on the checkbox to enable it. Marked in red are the areas which are overexposed, while purple indicates underexposed areas. The first thing is to make the switch to Filmic. Let's decrease the shadows value to bring up the underexposed areas. Notice how more areas are now marked as red. There are three parameters that can be used to control the overall exposure of the image: ISO, shutter speed, and F-number. Lower ISO values will bring down the exposure. The opposite is true for shutter speed and F-number. The higher the value, the darker the image. Let's also slightly decrease the highlights value, and we are ready to remove the false color LUT. Here's the difference between standard and Filmic. Right below the exposure section, we have the filtering options. We will be adding a bit of vignette which darkens the corners of the image, just like in real cameras. The white balance value will make the image warmer or cooler based on its value. LUT stands for lookup table and is used to color grade the rendered image. You can either use the pre-installed LUT files or add new ones in the Thea Data LUT folder. As we saw in part 1, we can have denoising while in interactive mode after first enabling interactive denoising from the Thea Render Settings panel. Denoise can also be applied in production mode. nice feature of the engine is the clay render mode located in the render settings panel. To turn this feature on, go to the clay renders rollout and tick the checkbox. Adjust the whiteness of the override material by adjusting the reflectance value. As you can see, it overrides all the scene materials with a generic one, while keeping the material's transparency and bump channel. This allows us to evaluate the lighting of the scene without being distracted by colors or textures. Production rendering is the process of generating the final image in the highest quality. One thing that we need to define is the final size of the image. To do that, let's go to the Camera tab and set the image resolution. Production rendering can only be done in the Thea Darkroom window. Let's open Thea Darkroom and click on the toggle button to switch to PR, which stands for production rendering. The next step is to define the termination criteria. We can either set a time or samples per pixel limit. The last thing that we need to do is to enable two render channels that are specific to denoising. These channels are normal denoise and raw diffuse denoise. We are now ready to start rendering by clicking on the start button. Let us also apply the denoiser by switching to the Intel OpenImage Denoise and ticking on the Denoise checkbox. Follow us to the third and last part, where we will be creating an interior scene. We will populate it with models and create a daylight and night shot of the scene. Thank you for watching.